हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू माय चैनल बायोलॉजी 360। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक वायरसेस, वीरोइड्स, प्रियॉन्स एंड लीचेंस। दिस टॉपिक इज हेल्पफुल फॉर स्टूडेंट्स प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर नीट, एम्स एंड ओलंपियाड एग्जाम्स एंड ऑल्सो फॉर स्टूडेंट्स from ICSC, CBSC, IGCSE and HSC board. The viruses are non-cellular organisms that are characterized by having an inert crystalline structure outside the living cell. So basically, viruses are non-cellular. They do not have a proper cellular organization. Once they infect a cell, they take over the machinery of the host cell to replicate themselves, killing the host. It means that when the virus enters inside the body of a host, it replicates or it multiplies at a very fast rate. And due to this, many times the death of the host occurs. Viruses are obligate parasites. Obligate means they require a host body for survival. It means that viruses cannot survive outside the living organism. They need living organism to survive. So living organism can be a plant, or it can be an animal cell, or it can be a bacterial cell as well. Viruses contain genetic material that could be either RNA or DNA. No virus contains both RNA and DNA. So viruses, they contain either RNA or DNA as the genetic material, but never both. Viruses that infect plants have single-stranded RNA. And viruses that infect animals have either single or double-stranded RNA or double-stranded DNA. Bacterial viruses or bacteriophage are usually double-stranded DNA viruses. So if the virus is a plant virus, they generally have a single-stranded RNA. If a virus is infecting any animal cell, it will have either single or double-stranded RNA or double-stranded DNA. The name virus was given by M.J. Bejarnik. So this scientist, he gave the term virus. The protein coat called capsid is made up of small subunits called capsomeres. It protects the nucleic acid. These capsomeres are arranged in helical or polyhedral geometric form. So viruses, they have a protein coat, and that protein coat is called as capsid. And the individual subunits of capsid is called as capsomeres. So this capsid, it protects the nucleic acid. So as I mentioned earlier, nucleic acid can be RNA or it can be DNA. So nucleic acid is protected by the capsid coat, which is made up of protein. So here we see the two pictures. This is a virus. It has capsid, and this capsid is protecting the RNA genetic material. In the other diagram, we see a bacteriophage. It has a head. Inside the head, there is DNA, a collar, a sheath, a basal plate, and tail fibers. So these are the different parts of a bacteriophage. Many times, students get the question to draw a well-labeled diagram of T4 bacteriophage. So this diagram is important. T4 bacteriophage. Viruses thus can be called infectious nucleoprotein particle. Viruses are always infectious whenever it enters inside the plant cell or an animal cell or a bacterial cell. It causes infection. So that's why it is called infectious nucleoprotein particles. Diseases caused by viruses in plants, such as leaf curling, yellowing of leaves, and mosaic formation. Mosaic formation means there is formation of light and dark green or yellow mosaic pattern on leaves. Diseases caused by viruses in animals are swine flu, bird flu, chickenpox, mumps, herpes, common cold, AIDS, rabies, etc. Next, we move on to viroids. In 1971, T.O. Diner discovered a new infectious agent that was smaller than viruses and it caused potato spindle tuber disease. So in 1971, one more infectious agent was discovered, and this infectious agent, it was smaller than a virus and it caused disease in a potato plant. It was found to be a free RNA. It lacked the protein coat that is found in viruses, hence the name viroid. So viroid, they have RNA as the genetic material. They do not have any protein coat called capsid. So this is the picture of a potato spindle tuber disease, which is caused by viroid. As you can see, the shape of the potato is not proper, and viroid infection has occurred in this plant. Let's move on to the next point, prions. So prions are an agent consisting of abnormally folded protein. So prions are basically the structures in which the protein structure is not proper. Abnormal protein are basically the prions. The most notable diseases caused by prions are bovine spongiform encephalopathy, BSE, commonly called mad cow disease in cattle, and Jacob disease in humans. So prions, they mainly cause diseases in animals as well as in humans. Jacob disease in humans. So Jacob disease is basically, it's a neurodegenerative disease. The neurons get degenerated in this disease. All known prion diseases in mammals affect the structure of the brain and other neural tissue. Lichens. Lichens are symbiotic association, that is mutually useful association between algae and fungi. The algal component is known as phycobiont and the fungal component as mycobiont. So lichens, in lichens, there is a symbiotic association between algae and fungi. The algal component is called as phycobiont and the fungal component is called as mycobiont. So when algae and fungi, when they live together, their association is known as lichens. Algae prepare food for fungi and fungi provide shelter and absorb mineral nutrients and water for its partner. So when algae and fungi, when they live together, when they form an association, they both help each other. Algae help by preparing food for fungi. Algae performs photosynthesis. And fungi, it help in absorption of mineral nutrients and water from the soil. Lichens are very good pollution indicators. They do not grow in polluted areas. So here in this slide, we can see the lichens growing on the tree trunks, on the barren rock. So this is how the lichens appear. There are certain important neat questions I have framed here. Question number one, who crystallized and isolated viruses for the first time? A. W.M. Stanley, B. K.M. Smith, D. Ivanovsky, D. F.C. Borden. And the correct answer is option A. Stanley. Question 2. Virion is nucleic acid of virus, B. Antiviral agent, C. Protein of virus, D. Completely assembled virus outside host. And answer is option D. It's an inert virus outside host. It's called virion. Question number 3. Association between mycobiont and phycobiont are found in A. Mycorrhiza, B. Root, C. Lichens, D. BGA. BGA stands for blue-green algae. And the correct answer is option C. Fourth, an association between roots of higher plants and fungi is called option A, lichens, option B, fern, option C, mycorrhiza, option D, BGA. And the correct answer is option C, mycorrhiza. Question number 5. Select the pair that consists of viral diseases. Option A, mumps and smallpox. Option B, herpes and influenza. Option C, pneumonia and syphilis. Option D, both A and B. And answer is option D, both A and B. Friends, I hope this video will surely help you in understanding about the viruses, prions, and virions. Do subscribe to my channel to get all the latest videos on biology. Thank you.